What will we do with this moment? How will we be remembered? This is our future and our choice to make. I am asking you to choose greatness.
Welcome back to Real Trump News. Real news President Trump doesn't want you to miss. First, Fox News is reporting that Attorney General William Barr said Sunday that the Department of Justice will treat violence by individuals associated with Antifa as domestic terrorism in a statement that condemned the far-left group. Barr's statement came after President Trump earlier Sunday said he would designate Antifa as a terrorist organization. Antifa, short for anti-fascist, has very little central organization but violent left-wing protesters, particularly in places like Portland, Oregon, often act under the Antifa banner. Barr said, with the rioting that is occurring in many of our cities around the country, the voices of peaceful and legitimate protests have been hijacked by violent radical elements. Groups of outside radicals and agitators are exploiting the situation to pursue their own separate, violent, and extremist agenda. Next, the New York Post editorial board writes, George Floyd's brother, Terrence Floyd, on Monday at the spot where his brother George died, he pleaded, "Do this peacefully, please. If I'm not over here blowing up stuff, messing up my community, what are you all doing?" he asked. It's an excellent question for not just the radical pushing violence, but also for the talking heads rationalizing it. From Manhattan to Portland, Oregon, rioters have been smashing storefronts and looting businesses, from Targets to high-end handbag stores to mom-and-pop shops, and voices throughout the media have told them that it's okay. Terrence Floyd noted, "Private property can be replaced, a life can't. That's not going to bring my brother back at all, and it does nothing to honor the memory of the gentle giant," Terrence described. "The rioters and their cheerleaders won't pay to fix the damage, insurance won't cover everything, and rates will rise in the impacted neighborhoods, adding to their economic struggle." The NYPD said 1 in 7 of those arrested in the melee are from out of the state, but some villains are local too. Miranda Devine writes in the New York Post on Tuesday night, "As Mayor Bill de Blasio went on CNN to lie to Chris Cuomo that all was calm in New York, the exhausted men and women of the NYPD were being bruised and battered for the fourth night by criminals running amok under the cover of George Floyd protests. As he spoke, the reality on the street was revealed in a video going viral on Twitter of a looting party in Soho, with hundreds of revealers miling around looted stores and dancing on cars. At the same time, over on Fox News, NYPD Surgeon Benevolence Association Chief Ed Mullen was making an extraordinary plea for the President Trump to intervene to rescue a mighty police force that has been hobbled and abandoned by its political masters. Mullen said, "The NYPD is losing the city of New York, and we have no leadership in the city of New York." For all that, de Blasio and Governor Andrew Cuomo still criticized the NYPD for using excessive force and refused to call out the National Guard. "Our hands are being tied," said Mullen. "We're being told to stand down. We have a city that's been destroyed. The public that lives there is in fear for their lives. Thanks to the hysteria being stoked by the media and Democrats, hoping for electoral advantages. Police are being killed and injured and abused to avenge the death of a man half a country away. The truth is that the police are just pawns in a political game," as Mullen said in a letter to his troops this week. And that's this week's Real Trump News. We will see you next time.